Hello, and welcome to the CHaMP Research Series on recent studies conducted by the CHaMP EMS Research Group. Today's lecture will be about a paper on destination decision-making for children transported by EMS. We'd like to start by acknowledging that this work was supported by the Health Resources and Services Administration, Maternal and Child Health Bureau of the Emergency Medical Services for Children Targeted Issues Grant Program, and that the content and conclusions are those of the authors and should not be construed as the official position or policy of the United States government or HRSA. Our objectives today are to describe the findings of a recent CHaMP study on pediatric destination decision making. We'd like to identify how this work applies to EMS practice and determine if this work applies to your practice. So all emergency departments across the United States should be pediatric capable. That means that if a child is brought to any emergency department, there should be the personnel, equipment, etc. available to help treat that child. However, the recent pediatric readiness studies found that not all emergency departments are ready to treat children. Further, even those that are ready and meet the recommendations for being prepared to provide treatment to children will not have some specialized resources. This includes clinicians, equipment, and services such as a pediatric ICU. Emergency medical services providers play a role in destination decision making. They have conversations with patients and their families about which hospital would be best suited to treat the needs of the child they are transporting. If a child is transported to an emergency department that is not capable of providing the needed care, this can lead to delays in treatment, such as if a specialized provider needs to be called to the hospital or specialty equipment needs to be obtained. Further, if that equipment or those clinicians are not available, then secondary transport may be needed to take the child to another hospital that has those resources, and this can increase both costs, but more importantly, can increase risk and delay the treatment of that child for whatever emergency they're being evaluated for. Recently, the CHaMP group published a paper called Multicenter Analysis of Transport Destinations for Pediatric Pre-Hospital Patients. This paper was published in 2019 in the Academic Emergency Medicine, Volume 26, pages 510 to 16, and can be obtained through the link shown. This study, in a nutshell, reviewed destination hospital type for all pediatric patients transported by EMS over 2 years in three mid-sized cities. These cities were Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Charlotte, North Carolina, Houston, Texas. And each of these cities had local protocols, all recommended that providers transport potentially severe traumas to a pediatric trauma center. They had limited recommendations in their protocols for medical patient destination decision-making. And finally, in each of these communities, we asked the local EMS medical directors to identify the hospitals in those cities that would be considered to have higher level pediatric resources. So we divided all the local hospitals or transportation destinations into two groups, those with higher level pediatric resources and those that are standard emergency departments. They evaluated 41,345 transported pediatric patients. 55% went to the highest level pediatric hospital. When this was broken down by age, we see again at the bottom of this chart, 55% of all children went to the higher level pediatric hospital. Looking by age though, we see that as age increased, the rate of going to a general emergency department also increased. So at the bottom, children less than 6 months, 65% of those kids went to the higher level hospital. While at the higher end, those kids who were 15 to 18 years old, 43% went to the higher level pediatric hospital. The remaining 57% went to a general emergency department. When we broke these kids down by chief complaint and destination, starting with all of the kids, all 41,000 patients that were evaluated, 55% again went to the higher level hospital. Looking at injured patients, 61% of all injured patients went to the higher level hospital. And of those with potentially severe injuries, and that was defined as meeting the physiologic criteria of the trauma triage guidelines, 74% went to a higher level pediatric hospital. So again, these communities had trauma triage guideline protocols that said that children who essentially met the physiologic criteria of the field triage guidelines should go to a pediatric trauma center. And what we found was 74% of those kids that met that criteria were going to that trauma center. When we looked at children with medical conditions or ill children, we found that 45% of children went to the higher level pediatric hospital. When we looked at children who potentially had severe illnesses, which we defined as at least one vital sign outside of an age-appropriate range, or a GCS score of less than 13, we found that 59% of kids went to the higher level hospital. So again, these communities didn't have a lot of guidance in their protocols for which hospital to transport to, and 59% of those with potentially severe medical complaints did not go to the higher level pediatric hospital. What does this mean? These were all communities with higher level pediatric hospitals within about 20 minutes of transport time from any location. We found that EMS in these locations transported kids to other facilities fairly regularly, even those that seemed to have conditions that might need specialty services. We also found that injured children were more commonly transported to the higher level pediatric facilities than ill children. So, as with any research, there were some limitations to this study. First of all, we looked only at the overall rate. So we didn't look at each individual child to see what services they needed. And we didn't look at the effect of this destination choice on outcome. So what that means is the study definitely doesn't say that these kids went to the wrong place. It just shows that it's surprising that more children were not going to that higher level facility, because that's what we assumed at the outset of this study. So what does this mean moving forward? Well, we think it's important that nationally we work to identify which children need the resources of a higher level pediatric facility, and that we work to develop evidence-based guidance for destination decision-making for children. We need to figure out who needs what and where they need to go. Regionally, we need to evaluate local hospital resources and provide guidance on destination decision-making to EMS providers. Specifically, we should consider incorporating destination decision-making recommendations into local EMS protocols. So, in conclusions, the findings of this study is that in communities with access to hospitals with higher level pediatric resources, children are not always being transported to those facilities. Even when EMS findings indicate the child potentially has a severe illness or injury. How do we apply these findings? Well, efforts should be initiated to develop evidence-based guidelines for destination decision-making for children. Communities should consider incorporating destination decision-making into local EMS protocols. And providers should understand the hospital resources in their community and help patients reach the destination with the resources that meet their needs. Thank you very much, and we hope you found this lecture useful.